Hello everyone, I'm Shikha Soni, Assistant Professor in Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering in Sagar Institute of Research and Technology. And Sagar Institute is comes under Sage Group in Bhopal and Indore, both of the places. So today we will learn how to analyze circuit by using mesh analysis. So we'll move forward. Suppose if there is a circuit which is given, and here we can see that this circuit is given. So here, by applying mesh analysis, we will find out the current which is present in each branch. Okay. So suppose first what we will do, we'll start bifurcating current from any particular node, and we know that if current is coming out or going out from a particular source, then it will bifurcate again from the node. Okay, suppose here we are considering that battery V1 is there and current I1 is flowing through this R0 ohm resistance, and secondly at node B it will bifurcate. So one current will be going through this R1 ohm resistor, which is I2, and another current, which is I3, is coming. From this voltage, and it is coming out from the voltage and going through R3 resistor. Okay. Now these all current will come down. Okay. And again from this voltage source, we'll see that this current will go from this direction, and this will, so it is negative, it will go from that direction. Okay. And one more thing which I want to tell you, that while writing down the mesh equation, so we supposed to always consider that current always be entering at positive node and will be leaving negative pole. Okay. So suppose if I want to draw, or I want to give polarity for a current. So if suppose this current is flowing through this resistor, so first we will give polarity, so it will be writing plus minus. Okay, suppose this current, this is I1, and suppose a current which is I2 going through minus to plus, so what will be the, suppose magnitude of both the currents are similar, same. So the relation between two currents will be I1 is equals to minus of I2. That means current always enters at positive node and tail which leaves negative node. Okay. If a similar amplitude of the current is going in the opposite direction, then of course their amplitude will be the same, but we'll represent direction with negative sign. Okay, so for analyzing mesh analysis, we will write down this plus and minus polarity across each resistor. So here it is entering from plus and leaving, entering to plus and leaving from minus. Here also it is entering and leaving minus. Now plus, minus. It is entering plus. Okay, and this current is leaving from this plus V3 battery, and I1 is leaving from plus V1 battery. This is plus, this is minus, this positive polarity which is shown by this small line, and the large line, which is the bigger line is there, which is exhibiting the polarity of plus. Okay, now for each loop, suppose this is L1, L2, L3. For each mesh, we will be writing down the equations. Suppose, okay, so we just gave the direction and we will write down equation. So again, as far as possible, try to shift current source into, so we supposed to shift the current source into voltage source without affecting the load element. Okay. And second is identify number of meshes. So that is the very basic thing. So we have seen that there were three meshes present. Then we have to assign mesh currents, which I told you in before, that while solving this mesh analysis, we have to give name of the currents to that corresponding branch. And how we will give the current name? Because there is a voltage source, so from positive terminal of the voltage source, current will start flowing, and whenever it is entering, it will be plus, and for leaving we'll use negative sign. Now we will apply KVL. So what is the meaning of KVL? Apply KVL means whatever equations will be, they will be in the form of V is equals to I into R. Okay. In nodal analysis, what we do, just opposite, we apply KCL, means current equation in terms of V by R. Okay. Now we will solve KVL equations using variable elimination methods or by applying Cramer's rule. So that I'll tell you okay, how to apply Cramer's rule to solve the mesh currents and finding out the value of it. Now find branch currents or branch voltage and power from the mesh currents using Ohm's law. So whenever when we will obtain the value of current, so through current we can take out the power, like P is equals to R, P is equals to V into I, and energy also, which is integration of P with respect to time. Okay. So thank you so much.